Casa Valentina is a comedy by Harvey Fierstein. It takes place in upstate New York in 1962 at a resort where male heterosexuals would go, sometimes with their wives, for the weekend to dress as females.
We've gone legit! As of this morning, the sorority is a legally recognized nonprofit organization registered with the United States of America.
Ladies, grab your kits and bits. Miranda has volunteered for a makeover.
Makeover!
One of the misunderstandings that society has about this group is they're not homosexuals. They're all, almost all of them are heterosexuals. They're all married. Some of them have grown children.
The judge's wife knows what he's up to. Still, for her, he pretends to be hunting. He hunts 30 weeks a year.
This is not ladylike behavior.
No, but this is.
Are you in trouble?
Me, no.
I'm broke. Dead broke. I'm a decorated war hero wearing a muumuu and a turban. Do you really want my advice?
We're conveying ideas that are political and social and emotional.
At its heart, a story about authenticity, and that's something I think everybody can relate to. But not only just about trying to be authentic, but the cost that exacts on not only the individual, but also the individuals that that person loves.
A good friend will always stab you in the front.
Truth is, when I was a teen, I fantasized I'd take one of my father's rifles and shoot you one by one. Kids. Growing up, I've come to realize I'm really only angry at him.
I think it's important so that we can manage to separate a person's outward expression with who they feel they are on the inside.
These people are still largely closeted.
All in all, life is better if we are true to our own creation.
I swore I'd never allow any action of mine, no matter how minute, to disclose my inner life to strangers. I have spent half a century perfecting that impenetrability. I owe my security and my peace of mind to the practice. I am sorry, but my privacy is non-negotiable.
Oh, but Amy, if there's one thing we old folks know, it's that things change in 50 years' time.
Things don't change, they rot.
Although it's set in 1962, everything it touches upon is still true today.
When you think about it rationally, if men want to dress up as women, who cares?
I don't know how women do it. I don't know why women do it. Why don't you just rise up and say, enough? No more Spanx, no more undergarments.
Extremely funny and extremely heartfelt.
I think of being a boy as my day job. Some try to make sense of it, some don't. There are those who are comfortable calling themselves the girl within.
You would be fine if this resort were to fill up with homosexuals?
I imagine homosexuals have many more fun places to go than the Catskills.
They estimate there's probably between 1.5 and 4 million men in this country who have this compulsion.
This is a minority that is struggling to find their place in the world.
Is it possible to feel right and terrified at the same time?
Daily, which is stronger?
I've tried to stop. I keep doing it.
There's your answer.
I hope everyone comes away open and hum in the tunes. There is some great music that David Lee's thrown in.
I hope they'll come away with two thoughts. One, that was absolutely fascinating. And the other one would be, I had no idea. Lollipop, lollipop, oh, lollipop, lollipop, a lollipop.